want to. I'm from Olananda group of districts, Rumoguta group, Kala district. I want to appreciate the name of the Lord for how the Lord healed me. For some time, I developed severe back pain, and the pain's persistence. Thereafter, with some other symptoms, I went for tests, and they told me that it was ulcer. And I kept believing God for a miracle, because I've been taking drugs, and most time I find it difficult taking the drugs, because for me, the drugs were too much for me to take. So during November crusade, a campus student gave a testimony of how the Lord healed her of ulcer. I keyed into that testimony and I said, God, if you can heal this girl, she's a young girl like me, you can also heal me. And I held on to that. And when I got home, I was just checking things and I came across the drugs again. Immediately, I picked those drugs and disposed them. I said, my God has healed me, within me. Which I didn't tell anybody. I didn't even allow my uncle to be aware of it because I don't know what they will say. So early this year, there was a day I went to work. I left my food at home. I didn't even know that God has healed me, but the Lord wanted to show to me that he has healed me. And I called someone that, please, tell someone to bring the food for me. Before they brought the food, around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And I was still at work then. And as I was at work, unlike before, I can't stress myself because if not, if I pass through a lot of stress, I'll start feeling the pains again. If I don't eat on time, I'll start. But that very day, since 3 o'clock, I didn't eat. I didn't experience any pain. Even when we were preparing for this GCK, we were asked to wait upon the Lord. As a result of that, I was involved. I fasted. Even when I came here on Thursday, I didn't experience any pain. Even yesterday when I went for impact, unlike me, I must eat in the morning. I went for impact, I didn't eat. Till the impact was over and there was no pain, nothing, no symptoms of the ulcer again. I want to say, may the name of the Lord be glorified.
Put your hand together for Jesus.
Secondly, early this year, I couldn't use my right hand again because the pain was so much. Even writing became a problem, because the whole of my fingers and my palms were full of pains, which I told someone about it. She said, I've forgotten what she was trying to explain to me the cost. Because I made up my mind, I said, I won't take any drugs. During January crusade, when GS was always praying, I would raise my two hands up and I believe God for a miracle. And I didn't even know when the healing took place. It was when I noticed that I was healed was when a child did something, I slapped the child with my right hand. And it was after I gave the child the slap, I remembered, come, this hand was paining me. And it is the same hand I used to slap this child. I didn't feel any pain. And since then, I've been able to use my right hand. I want to say, may the name of the Lord be glorified in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. She was healed of peptic ulcer disease and maybe painful arthritis of the hand. Praise the Lord.
You will not see it again. The next.
Our next testifier is Madam Edna Okocha. And she too, she has a testimony of the goodness of God in answers to prayers. Praise the Lord.
Brethren, praise the Lord. Praise the living God. My name is Sister Edna Okocha. By the grace of God, I'm saved. I'm of Rumokoro O District, Port Harcourt Region, Rivers State. I want to appreciate the Lord for what he has done for me. So many times the Lord has done good things for me in area of deliverance, healing. But this particular one happened last year. I've been having this problem under my ribs here with a very big heart thing. The thing is here. But each time I go for a test, they will say there's nothing. I've gone up to 5 scans for them to check. In the hospital, they said they see water, or it's gas, or it's fluid. They say there's nothing. But within me, I am the one feeling it inside me. At a stage, I keep on losing weight, you know. So I believe in God, praying unto God. Until last year, November, the GCK that held at Benin, that's our pastor said we should lay our hands where we are having problem. I raised my top and lay my hand there. I'm telling you, brethren, it was like I was fainting. And the man of God was praying. The power came up. I was bending down, looking how to stand up. The power was so much on me. And after that prayer that day, my health began to recover. I started getting myself. Praise the Lord. The second one is yesterday, after the prayer of the man of God, when I came to the crusade, I was having stomach ache. The tummy was biting me. And I was telling a sister beside me that I have a drug here to take, but in the crusade here, how can I take drug? I believe in God's divine healing. And that before I leave the crusade, I will get my healing. And after our daddy in the Lord prayed, that was how the thing subsided. And I got my healing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living God. I want you to believe God, whatever is your heart desire. Believe God, keep on praying, and the Lord that has done it for me, he will do for you also in Jesus' name. May the name of God be highly exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen. Our sister talked about a cystic lesion around her left rib and abdominal pain, which has been healed by the power of God. Praise the Lord.
As the Lord has touched you, that's final. You will not see it again in Jesus' name. Let's take some songs.
Thank God for my life once again. This is a Friday. I was coming to this program. I didn't hear very well. And secondly, my elder was disturbing me. So after the end of this prayer, the man of God said that whatever he was spending, you put it in that place. So I want to put my hand in my head. At the end of the prayer, everything will disappear. I can hear very well now. He can talk to me now. I can hear very well. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. He had sudden headache, which affected his ears, and he had impaired hearing. So according to him, he wasn't hearing with the two ears, but with the prayer of the man of God, he was healed and he can hear clearly now. Praise the Lord.
Put your hand together if you want to clap for Jesus.
Our next testifier is Mr. Olajide Akinlola, and he also has a testimony of God's.
Praise God. Praise God. Praise the Lord. I'm really happy this night. I have a very great testimony to testify this night. Like, I always have this sharp pain at the left side of my chest, at my heart. I always have this fear that I'm having issue with my heart, because I always have many people that have died of heart issue. So like, right from when I was little, it's recently I told my mother about that sharp pain. Each time I tried to breathe, she now told me that, why is it that it's now I'm telling her, right from small, I've not told anybody, I always fight with it. So there are sometimes I will just sit like this. If you just touch me, like, I would just be afraid. Let nobody just near me. Once I sit down that place, where I am, sometimes you tell me that I should give you something. like I would just pray that let some, nobody just send me message that moment, because that place I'm sitting, that moment, if I move, I don't know what will happen next. Because even when I try to breathe, the pain will increase. So I'll start breathing small until it start going. It was last month that it now entered another dimension. Whereby that area will start vibrating to the downside. So I was like, what is the meaning of this? I beg you, hope this is not the heart issue that other people have always had and died. So when I came, this is my first day of coming, I was invited. So when Papa Kumi, he made a statement that we should raise our hand up and place the giraffe of our hand on the place where we are having the issue. When I placed my hand there, with faith, the vibration stopped. And I want to give all glory to God who has made this happen. I just thank God that at least this one that's happened now is a very great testimony. Something I've been suffering right from when I was little, and I've been keeping it silent. And last month, it entered on that dimension, vibrating, serious vibration to the downside of my chest, loose my stomach here. And I want to give glory to God who has made this miracle.
Praise the Lord. So he had symptoms, possibly of cardiac disease. He had palpitations, that's the heart beating, as I said. But God has healed it. Whatever it was, the Lord God himself has taken care of it. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story, rewriting my soul.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have here Mrs. Rosalyn Monday, and she has a testimony of God's goodness. Please go ahead.
Church, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm here to testify of God's wonderful touch on my life. For long, very long time, I've been having excruciating pain all over me. Sometimes it will just moving round about right inside me. And wherever this pain stop, that place will be paining me and be stiff. And I cannot even, you know, gather myself. But to the glory of God, this time of this crusade, I prayed in my house. I said, God, let me have the first day miracle. When I prayed that God give me the first day miracle, which was on Thursday, I came here on Thursday. The pain become worse, even while in the ushering stand where I was ushering. The pain was so terrible at my back. I said, I want to have my first miracle. Is it now that this pain has come back? So I just prayed to the point that when I go, after that day, I went to the hostel. I called a sister. I said, sister, please, you come and massage me. You come and massage me, because the pains I'm having now is too much. I can't. She said, okay, the next day she will come to massage me. That next day, in the morning, we all went to a minister's conference. As we went there, came back. The next day, that being Thursday evening, that pain, when it disappeared, I couldn't know. I couldn't even remember that I was having pain. I didn't know until, you know, today. I had to say, I was having this pain. Where? How? I have soundness, wellness inside of me. All the pain disappeared. And from Mboshimi, Room Olumeni Old Group, Mboshimi Group, that's where I come from. The way God touched me, my brother, I believe, just believe God, he will touch you. He will not go back empty. As I did not go back empty, you will not go back empty.
Put that
in
hand
Jesus
for
name.
Jesus.
Amen. Praise the
Who
Lord.
Who has done it? Our Jesus has done it again.
Praise the Lord.
Our next testifier is Mrs. Patience Martins. Go ahead with your testimony.
Church, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Our Lord is good. My name is Sister Patience Martins. I'm serving the Lord in the District Church of New Layout in Ozodo Group, Ozoba Old Group in River State. Praise the Lord. And in Nigeria. Our God is a good God. The God of GCK is a good God. May his name be praised in Jesus' name. Jesus told me in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 that I should seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, that every other thing should be added unto me. And since that day, I've always done what he said, and the many, many things have been adding to my life. Praise the Lord. More than 2 years now, I've been suffering from what the doctor called a tinnitus, a ring in the ear. It happened one night when I was lying down. My phone was beside my pillow, by my ear side. I was expecting a call from my husband. So when the phone rang, it rang right inside my eardrum. From that day, my memory, everything about my head was affected. I started suffering this. I from chemist and go to hospital. They told me that it doesn't have cure, that I should be treating malaria when possible, and they always take pain reliefs. And they gave me many, and I was taking it to no avail. When I go to church, I will not stay steady inside the church. I will go run out and come in, run out and come in. Sometimes my pastor, Pastor Kevin, will tell me, sister, you don't need to be running out of the church because of this pain. Stay there and it will go. And obediently, I will stay. And I continue battling with this problem. I didn't know when it disappeared. Children of God, praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
I didn't know when it disappeared. I started noticing I can't find it again. When it starts, my children cannot on television where I am. I mean, spoon will not fall on the floor where I am because I will feel it. It will look as if a helicopter is passing by my side. It will look as if tipper is tipping sand. Anytime, anywhere I am, I will be hearing When it's happening, I'll be having headache, and this part of my shoulder will be paining me, and I'll be drying. But the God of heaven, through GCK, have taken it away. Praise the Lord! I confirmed it fully on Tuesday when we came for key leaders meeting. I was sitting right there, and this speaker was just right at my ear, left hand ear. And I didn't feel anything until the program finished. And when they said that Tuesday we should come out for testimony, I told my husband, I said, I'm going to give my testimony. He said, for what? I said, the ear. He said, yes, yeah, since we came here, I've been watching you if you will act the way you used to act when you are by the speaker side, and they have not seen you act that way. Go and give your testimony. Children of God, our God is a miracle-working God. He has healed me of that sickness. The doctor told me that he does not have cure. May his name alone be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My second testimony is yesterday. It happened yesterday morning. From here, we traveled home to the burial of my local government for burial. As we was going, when we get to Igrita Junction, our motor fell break. But to the glory of God, my husband controlled the vehicle, and we did not hit the motor that was by our front. I didn't really understand what God did for us. Not until when we were looking for mechanic to put the brake in order. We were moving slow, 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 slow like ants. When we get after the Chokocho Bridge, we saw mechanic. The mechanic was just showing us a vehicle that failed brake last night of the Friday before that Saturday morning that destroyed the vehicle that was parked. He said that one just failed brake. And I saw how the vehicle destroyed another one that was parked, and the everything that happened there, say God. So Breath failure is a dangerous thing. I say, God, who did not allow our own to get to that extent, may his name alone and alone be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. She had what she called tinnitus, which was, there was sound trauma to the inner ear. So the cochleas and some things that are there that takes care of balance and sound, they were destroyed. But God, by his mercy, healed it. Praise the Lord.
No more sound of woo or helicopter. Everything is gone. Put your hand together for Jesus.
Our next testifier is Madam Precious Ezugo. Go ahead.
Praise the Lord. My name is Precious Ezugo. I live at Moshu. I'm here to thank God for what God did for my son, David Ezugo. Since I gave birth to this child have hernia. And this hernia, sometimes the hernia will go inside. But when he cries very hard, the hernia will just shoot out. And when the thing shoot out, you see me that have this child, I will cry and say, God, I don't have money to take this child to hospital to operate this child. And they say, as this child is little, that when they operate this child, maybe this child will die. When the woman that I was working with, she said she go to teaching hospital, that they will check him. I went there, they checked him. They said they will operate him, but I said I don't have the money for the operation yet, because at that time the child was 1 year plus. I said, I don't have the money to operate him from the hernia. So I still believe on God. Then, when our papa, our daddy, Kumuyi, came for having a crusade in this thing, India, he said, he have lose us and let us go. I believe in that word that he said. He said, lose him and let him go. I said, God, you have lost this my son. You have lost him and let him go from this hernia. I don't have money to take this child to a hospital to operate him. But you that have this child, you operate him for me. I still believe on this the word of the man of God. I said, he have lost us from every afflictions of the enemy. I still believe. Sometimes the hernia will shoot, it will not shoot again. Since that time, the hernia did not shoot again till January. The hernia came up again. I say, God, this thing have come out again. No, I say, okay, we are coming for, when I hear the program that we are coming for crusade this February, I say, okay, I will come. As we came to this program like this, the hernia just shoot out again. I say, okay, Satan, you're a liar. This is the time you will heal this child. God, you are going to heal this child for me from this hernia. And then, because when this child cry, you will see the hernia like this, the tomb will shoot out like this. You that owns this child self, you beat it for himself, because the ball will just shoot out so strong like this. I say, God, you will heal this child.
Now?
I let them, as the man of God was praying, he said we should lay our hands on wherever we are having problems. And that every problem will go to our feet. That will just run out to go down to our feet. I still believe that. As I believe and I pray for this child, that the man of God finished praying for this child. The boy that was here, I did not see the boy again. I look for the boy. I naked him. I check. I did not see the boy. I came here to say, God, thank you for healing this boy from every hernia. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. A hernia, what she says shooting out, when you have a hernia, that means that there's a defect in the wall, the normal abdominal wall, so that the intestines and the things that are inside, they come out. So that's what she calls shooting out. But by God's grace, God has, normally you do it through surgery to close that gap. But we believe and we know that the Lord God has created a covering, and it will be permanent in Jesus' name.
It's gone and gone forever. Put your hand together for Jesus. the last testimony.
With me here is Madam Comfort Awunade, and she too has a testimony.
Church, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My name is Comfort Awunade, and I live here in Port Harcourt. I attended the morning service, and it was my first time here. During the morning service, God healed me of a pain in my leg. Then secondly, for over a week, I've been feeling a terrible pain on my shoulders and a heaviness on my hand. I couldn't raise the hand, and I can't raise it up for a long time. Then I had a balm in my bag that I carry about. I was always using it to massage the hand. So during the prayer, Pastor asked that we should lay our hands where we feel pain. I did. And after the prayer, I just felt a relief, like something left my hand. I can lift my hand and roll it. This was what I couldn't do before. And I've been pressing my hand since. I can no longer feel the pains.
Praise the Lord.
You will not see the pain anymore in Jesus' name. Let's rise up and jubilate tonight and glorify His name. Mighty God indeed. The mighty advocate. Rejoice everywhere. Glory. Our God has done great things all over. Put your hand together, mighty God. Let's thank the Lord for what He has done for us today. Let's appreciate Him. Let's exalt His holy name. Our God is great. He has honored His name. The name of Jesus is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. Appreciate God. Thank Him for all that He has done this night all over the globe. Bless His holy name. Let's thank the Lord for His servant He used, that He will refill him the more. Tomorrow is another day. The minister's conference is there. You will not miss it. Let's raise up on our hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for all that you have done. Receive all glory. Receive all honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, we thank you. Father, we exalt you. There is none like you. You have gathered your people all over the globe. You have touched their life. You have changed many lives. You have restored many souls. And I pray, God, with all you have done this night, make it permanent in Jesus' name. They will never remain the same. Even as they are gone to their various places, you will visit them. You will touch them. And by the time they wake up, they have testimony to give. Lord, for your servants, envelop him more with your power. Use him more. And that come what may tomorrow, minister's conference, heaven will be open. Bless everyone. As we go now, Lord, go with your people. No evil shall befall anyone in Jesus' name. We know, Lord, with all that you have done for us, take all the glory, take all the honor. In Jesus' holy name, I pray. Amen. God bless you all. presence, before his presence with thanksgiving, and make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. In verse 3, for the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In verse 4, in his hand are the deep places of the earth. The strength of the hills is his also. Verse 5, the sea is his, and he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Verse 6, oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Praise the Lord. We want to begin, as we are lifting up our hearts to him, to appreciate our great maker, our God, about what he has been doing for us. Let's lift up our voices now and thank him for this great vision, the GCK, an awesome vision through which God has been visiting his people in many nations across the globe. Lift up your voice and appreciate the Lord. Thank him for the vision. This vision, this great vision, is awesome. It was given to the convener of the GCK, our father in the Lord, Pastor Dr. W.F. Komui. Let's thank the Lord Almighty for this great vision. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. God has used him to accomplish great and mighty things. Salvation of souls, the spread of the gospel all over the world, great deliverances of the oppressed, healing of those that are afflicted, restoration of spiritual experiences. There are many things, many, many things. I believe that you that is praying, you have a testimony, you have a reason to give God glory. Widespread miracles, signs, and wonders that defy medical solution. They have been testified in the course of the GCK. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. Bless his holy name. Thank him for all that he's doing. God has used this GCK and the appendage programs to groom and nurture leaders all over the globe. God has used it to bring the youths and young adults into focus, into development. Thank God Almighty for the ministries and the ministers that have bought into this program. A lot of ministries all over the world. Ministers all over the world have bought into it. It is the doing of God. Let's thank God for these godly ministers that God has used. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. Give him glory, give him honor, give him adoration. Thank God Almighty for all he has done. He's our mighty God. Thank God for their support. Thank God. Thank God. Please, if you have a testimony, please, you can come forward and go to my left so that you can be interviewed to give your testimony. And if you were interviewed before, but you have not given your testimony, you can also come out and go to the left, to my left, so that you can be interviewed. We are still thanking the Lord. Let's thank the Lord Almighty for the great testimonies we have been hearing. Awesome testimonies. Testimonies that baffle the mind. Testimonies that show that God is still in the business of healing, of performing signs and wonders. Let's thank the Lord Almighty for his goodness. Let's thank him. The blind are seeing. The dumb can talk. The deaf, their ears are unstopped. And the lame walk. Let's thank the Lord. Even the dead have been raised in this program. Open your mouth and thank the Lord. Please, if you are not yet in the crusade ground praying, please make sure you come here immediately.
The participants are here storming heaven, prevailing in prayers. Come and join. Prepare yourself for the evening program. Let's thank the Lord. Let's glorify God. Let's give him honor. Let's give him praises. Let's give him adoration. Amen. In Isaiah chapter 43, in verse 19, the Bible says, "Behold, I will do a new thing. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth." From this Alpha location, we are going to pray that God will do a new thing. Open your mouth and pray. Say, "God, oh God, do a new thing." We have been hearing of testimonies. We have been hearing of different miracles and all that. But there are still new things for God to do. Great things for God to do. It depends on your prayers. These new things that will come about is hinged on the way you pray this evening. I want you to open your mouth and tell the Lord, "Do a new thing." Pray that the Lord will do a new thing. From this Alpha location, let the Lord do a new thing. A new thing all over the globe. In America, let God do a new thing. In the Caribbean, let God do a new thing. Open your mouth and pray. In Europe, let God do a new thing. In the Middle East, pray that God will do a new thing. Pray that God will do a new thing. In India, everywhere, let God do a new thing. Wherever people are gathered, wherever people are assembled together for this crusade, is it online? Is it physically? Open your mouth and pray. Oh Lord, do a new thing. God will do a new thing as you pray. I want you to open your mouth and pray. Lift up your voices. This is the time to pray, lifting up your voices. Pray and tell the Lord, "Do a new thing. Do a new thing. Do a new thing. Do a new thing." God will do it. Open your mouth and pray. And tell the Lord to do a new thing. A new thing in this crusade ground. In your life, a new thing. In your family, a new thing. In your district church, a new thing. In your old group, a new thing. In your country, a new thing. A new thing. Let the Lord do it. Lift up your voices now and pray. Those with testimonies you are being waited for, go to my left. If you are interviewed, you have not given your testimony, please proceed there immediately. We are prevailing in prayers. The theme of this crusade is prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. If you are not prevailing, you are not doing the right thing. You have to prevail. Prevailing in prayers means that you will take prayer from the depths of your heart. You are focused to God and God alone. Nothing distracts you. Nothing around you distracts you. Open your mouth and call upon the Lord this evening. In Colossians chapter 2, you know, when you are praying, you are in a battlefield. And I want to tell you, you are in a battlefield. You have to note that, and you have to know how you are praying. In Colossians chapter 2, in verse 15, "And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it." Make no mistake. The adversary that we are facing is a formidable enemy, but he is already defeated. Can I hear an amen? I want a bigger amen. I said the enemy is defeated in Jesus' name. The enemy is defeated in Jesus' name. You are therefore not fighting, you know, from a losing position. You are fighting from the position of victory because he is defeated. I want to tell you that we are not fighting for victory. not fighting for victory, but because we already have victory. A bigger amen. A bigger amen. So you need to lift up your voice now and summon the power of God to come down upon this crusade gown. Let his power come down from on high. Open your mouth and pray. Say, Lord, send down your power. Send down your power. Let your awesome power come down. Let the power of God come down right now upon the crusade ground, upon all the locations worldwide, all over the world, in America. Let the power of God come down. In India, let the power of God come down. In the Caribbeans, let the power of God come down. Wherever people are assembled for the prevailing prayers crusade, let the power of God come down. Open your mouth and pray. It is the prayer that you pray from this Alpha location that will lead other prayers. As you open your mouth and call upon the name of the Lord, as you trust God and have faith in what God is going to do, you see what God is going to do. I tell you, your prayer means so much, and that's why I'm calling upon you right now. Open your mouth and pray down the power of God. Pray down the power of God in every location. Let the power of God manifest all over the globe. All over the globe. Let the power of God manifest. Open your mouth and call upon the Lord. Let his power manifest. Lord, let your power manifest. Lord, let your power manifest. Pray that the power will manifest to save sinners, to save sinners, to save sinners who Christ died for. Christ died for them. And that's why the Bible tells us that he made a public show of the enemy. Open your mouth and pray. The sinners, all those who don't have a relationship with Christ, wherever they are right now, in any location, pray that the Lord will visit them. The Lord will touch them. The Lord Almighty will touch their hearts, and they will surrender to God. They will surrender their lives. Open your mouth and pray. Pray that the Lord Almighty will visit sinners. We're praying from a position of victory. We have already defeated the enemy. He's a defeated foe. Jesus defeated him for us. And whatever we are pronouncing now, we are pronouncing over the work that Christ has done for you and I. Open your mouth and pray. Call upon the Lord. Let him heal the sick today. Any that is sick, wherever they are. Whatever may be the sickness that has defied medical solution, that is what God is noted for, to do great and mighty things. Open your mouth and pray. Perhaps you know somebody who is sick. You are free to mention the name of that person. You know somebody who has some long-standing sickness, illness, some long-standing disease. This is the time for you to mention his name so that God will locate that person wherever he is. Today, there will be miracles galore. Amen. Amen. I want us to pray and prevail. I want to hear the children of God prevailing. If you are going to prevail, I want to hear a loud amen. We are going to pray. We are going to ask the Lord to set those that are oppressed free. There are many in bondage, that the Lord will set them free. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord, set the oppressed free. Set them free. Set them free. Many are under bondage. Many are under manacles that are holding them down. They cannot even move out to serve God. They cannot respond to the call to come and serve God, to come and worship God. I want you to open your mouth now and loose them. Open your mouth because you have the power. The Bible said, behold, I give unto you what? Power. Open your mouth and pray. Exercise that power right now. Open your mouth and pray. And tell the Lord, loose all those that are under manacle, all those that are under chains, all those that are captives to the devil. Pray, prevailing prayer. We prevail against any circumstance. Prevailing prayer, we prevail against any condition. Prevailing prayer, we prevail against any challenge. Open your mouth and pray. Prevailing prayer. I want you to summon the power of God. Summon his power. Tell the Lord, bring your power down. Let him come and display his power. pray that God will display his power. Open your mouth and pray and call upon the Lord. God will do it. God will do it. Ask God to summon his awesome might. Pray that he will summon it. He will summon his might, even in this ground and all over the globe. I want you to pray, let God summon his might. Let God help you to prevail in this prayer. Prevailing prayers, crusade. Prevailing prayers. Ask him to parade his power. Let God parade his power. By the time the power of God is in parade, the devil will be cringing. I want you to open your mouth and pray. Lord, parade your power in all the grounds. The power of God will be let loose this evening. The power of God will be paraded this evening. Open your mouth and pray. I believe you are praying wherever you are. You are not doing anything else. You are praying. Pray and call upon the Lord. Pray and call upon the Lord. Pray and say, parade your power, O God. Parade your power, O God. The passion in your heart will determine what God will do with your prayer. This evening, I want you to pray passionately. I want you to pray from the depths of your heart. Let God see the passion, the burden that is in your heart about this thing we are praying for. And you'll see how God is going to respond. Open your mouth, call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. The chief reason why we are here and why people are assembled all over the globe for this prevailing prayer crusade is so that souls that Christ died for will be redeemed. Christ has finished the work of redemption, and therefore nothing should hold back those people. And Jesus said, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. That's what we are doing. You are doing it by proxy. You are praying here. You have been praying, and you are praying, and you continue to pray. You are doing it by proxy. And God will touch those sinners. God will bring them to salvation. God will redeem them. And if God redeemed them, you know for sure that you have your blessings. You have your blessings. Open your mouth and pray for them. Pray that the Lord will redeem the sinners, that God will bring them to salvation. I want to hear you pray prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. I want to hear you pray. Open your mouth and pray prevailing prayers. Prevailing prayers. Pray for all the sinners. All the sinners, wherever they are. Those that don't have a relationship with God. Those who have not received salvation. Are they here? Pray for them. Are they part of your family members? Pray for them. Are there people you know in your neighborhood? Pray for them. I want you to pray that the Lord Almighty will locate them. God will connect them in this crusade and touch their lives and change their lot. They will be redeemed from their sin. Open your mouth and pray for them. In Jesus' name, we pray. As if I can't hear your voice, in Jesus' name, we pray. That's better. I want a louder amen now. In Jesus' name, we pray. The devil is already shuddering. The Bible said, the heart of kings are in the hands of God. The heart of kings are in the hands of God. The kings of our time, those VIPs, those politicians, those big, big men that live behind fences, walls, where fenced houses with big gates, iron gates, with fierce dogs that don't allow people to go in to go and evangelize. We have invited them. We have sent the link to this crusade to many of them. We are going to pray that they will realize as they watch, as they participate in this crusade that God loves them. The heart of kings are in the hands of the Lord all those distinguished personalities in our land, in all other places, all over the globe, wherever they are, let us pray that God will visit them. Christ died for all. Open your mouth and pray that God will visit them. Visit these distinguished personalities. Visit them, O Lord. Visit them, O Lord. Give them salvation. Let them repent from their sin. Let them repent from their ways. Pray that the Lord Almighty will help them. Let them see the love of God, because it is the love of God that will draw them closer. Let them see the love of God. Let them realize the love of God. Even tonight, as the man of God comes on the podium to come and preach the gospel, let's pray that the gospel will have its effect on their hearts. Open your mouth and pray and call upon the Lord. What you are doing now is one of the greatest service you are doing in the kingdom of God. Praying that people will surrender, will be redeemed, will come and become bona fide citizens of the kingdom of God. Open your mouth and pray and call upon the Lord. Ask God to do it. Look, let me tell you, there was this man in the Bible. He's called Nicodemus. He went stealthily. He went and he found Jesus. Nicodemus did. There was this Ethiopian eunuch. He too was a man of authority, a big man, so to say. But he received the gospel of Christ and he became born again. There was also this centurion who heeded the godly counsel of a little girl. Let's pray that God in his own way will visit each and every one of these distinguished personalities, that God will show them his love, that God will draw them nearer. After this crusade, we want to see them in the church where they are going to be built up. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord to do it. God will do it. Just call upon the Lord and tell the Lord your heart desire. Of course, you know the heart desire of the righteous shall be granted. If your heart desire is to make sure that these distinguished personalities, that God touches their life, that God redeems them, that God brings them out of darkness into his marvelous light, if that is your desire, God will do it. Tonight, God will do it. Open your mouth and pray. Lord, show them your love. Let them realize your love. Open your mouth and pray. Lord, let them realize your love. And as they realize the love of God, you will see how God will bring them. They will come in. They will come into the fold. Open your mouth and pray. Pray. Ask God to do it. Pray that the Lord will help them so that their lofty positions that they are occupying will not blind their eyes to the need to come to Christ, the need to come to salvation, the need to prepare for heaven, the need to make heaven at last. Open your mouth and pray. Call upon the Lord. God will do it. Pray that God will do it. That the negative influence of the trappings of their positions, the trappings of their offices, will not hinder them tonight. It will not hinder them. Cry unto the Lord. Cry unto the Lord, my brother. Cry unto the Lord, my sister. Salvation for the affluent. Salvation for those that are influential. Salvation to every one of them. Open your mouth and pray that God will do it. Pray now that all over the globe, in every GCK location, whether online or physically, that the gospel will bring forth fruits unto salvation. Abiding fruits. Abiding fruits. Abiding fruits. Let the gospel bring them. Open your mouth and pray. We want this very crusade to be one that will shake the nations. A crusade that will make the nations to be shaken by the gospel. When great men in each nation give their lives to Christ, I tell you, it will make a wave in such countries. In the book of Haggai, I want to read chapter 2. I want to read Haggai chapter 2 and in verse 7. Haggai chapter 2 in verse 7, the Bible says, "And I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts." We are going to pray now that God Almighty will shake the nations. Righteousness will be the watchword in every nation. Those big people, those distinguished people, they will give their lives to Christ. Even the leaders of nations will give their life to Christ. God can do all things. Nothing is impossible with him. Only pray with faith. Only pray this prevailing prayer and believe it, and you see what God is going to do. God will do it. God has been doing it. Pray that the righteousness of the gospel we spread in all the nations of the world. The power of God unto salvation. This gospel will be preached by our Father in the Lord. And when he preaches it, this night, even tonight, something will happen. I want you to pray and ask God to do it. Let's pray for all the programs that are attached to the GCK, that the Lord will help us. Look at the Converse Rally. We want God Almighty to give us the strength, the power, the willingness, the diligence to go out and gather all our friends who have given their lives to Christ. Make sure that we'll bring them. Pray that the Lord will help you. You yourself, you will do it. And the Lord Almighty will give you the grace. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. You that is there, we're about to round up, but you that is there, why are you here? When I was coming here on Thursday, I saw many people in a fair. They were engaged in enjoyment and all that. But you are not so. You came here because you want to have an encounter with God. And that's why you came here. That's why you made it to this place. You are not here on a jamboree. So what do you want? What do you want? I want to show you a scripture. Then we are going to pray. In 1 Chronicles chapter 4. 1 Chronicles chapter 4. I read to you from verse 9 and verse 10. You know the story. Look at it. It says, "And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow." His name connotes sorrow, sadness, sorrow. That is terrible. Verse 10, "And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he desired." There are three basic things Jabez prayed for. What do you want to pray for? He said, "Bless me indeed." He was specific. "Enlarge my coast. Keep me from evil." What are you desirous of God? Why not talk to the Lord now as we round up? What do you want God to do? In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty Father, we thank you for the privilege to call upon your name and present our heart desires, our petitions to you this evening. We know you are a prayer answering God. We know that all that we have asked of you, answers have come already. We pray that tonight's program will be better than all those in the past. In the name of Jesus, thank you, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
If you are here, happy to be here tonight, can I hear a loud hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Wherever you are, please, let's be on our feet as we worship God together. We give you glory I'll be here. shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The hour has come. The hour has come. The hour has come. The hour has come. Father, glorify your name. The hour has come. Father, glorify your name. The hour has come.
The hour
you can give us a
Tonight,
oh,
the
lame will walk tonight.
I said
the
blind must see tonight.
Oh,
Together for Jesus everywhere. Yes, tonight heaven will be open. God will put smiles to every face tonight. Put your hand together for Jesus. The more you clap, the miracle you receive. The louder you're clapping, the miracle, the breakthrough, the success. Say amen. Tonight is tonight. In Isaiah chapter 35, I read verse number 3. Strengthen ye the weak hands and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that of fearful hearts, be strong. Fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. Even God with a recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf shall be unstopped. Then shall the lame man leap as a hart, and the tongue of the dumb sing. For in the wilderness shall the waters break out, streams in the deserts. Say amen. Tonight, anywhere you are, God will locate you. In Asia, in America, in Africa, in Europe, anywhere, God will locate you tonight. We are going to take a hymn, but let's pray briefly. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for what you are doing and what you're going to do tonight. I pray, O Lord, all over the globe, you will touch every heart. There will be miracle for your people. Break every yoke. As we continue now, continue with us. In Jesus' holy name, I pray. And everybody say, let's take a hymn now. We'll be taking our hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what a peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Are we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will our sorrows share? Jesus knows every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, combined with a load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he will take and shield thee. Thou with a solace there. We'll hear from the organists.